So today we are going to start with our virtual tour to the country Qatar. For the today's flight, pilot is Tarika. The co-pilot is Nandi, that is me, along with the crew member Indrani. So over to you, Tarika.
Good afternoon, guests. Today, we all gonna learn about the country Qatar. We will start with a small introduction about the Qatar. Next. Qatar is a peninsular Arab countries whose terrain comprises with arid desert and a long Persian Arab Gulf, shoreline of beaches and dunes. Also, on the coast is the capital Doha, known for its futuristic skyscrapers and other ultra-modern architectures, inspired by ancient Islamic design, such as the Milestone Museum of Islamic Art. The museum sits on the city's Corniche waterfront, Promenade. From its history and society, please mute everyone. Thank you. From its history and society to its geography and multicultural populations, Qatar is one of the most fascinating countries on earth. Whether you have been here for 10 days or even for 10 years, there is always something new to learn. We will talk about the art and culture in Qatar. Qatar has a thriving arts and culture scene with a large number of museums and galleries showcasing the country's history along with contemporary art featuring Arab artists. Next. Next slide, please. Okay, previous one, please. Qatar of map. Okay, thank you. In this slide, we can see the map of Qatar. The Qatar Peninsula is approximately 188 kilometers long and 85 kilometers wide. The country includes a small number of islands.
Ma'am, can I tell the airlines of Qatar?
You can tell at the end after my presentation is completed, okay?
Okay. Ma'am, excuse me, ma'am. When I join the laptop, I cannot come, ma'am.
Sorry?
I don't know what is it. Ma'am, when I join in my laptop, I cannot join the Kids World Tour.
Okay, now you are joining up. Now you are joined.
Now I have been joined only in mobile.
Okay, no problem. Okay, I will continue. The country includes a small number of islands, reefs, and shoals in the coastline water of the peninsula. Qatar has a population of 2.7 million people, including Qataris and non-Qataris. Only about 25% of the country's citizens are women. The map shows Qatar and neighboring countries with international borders, administrative boundaries, the national capital Doha, municipality centers, major town, main roads, and major airports. Largest cities in Qatar are Doha, Al Rayyan, and Salal Muhammad. Next. The national flag of Qatar is in the ratio of 11:28. It is the maroon with a broad white centered band, 9 white points which you can see, okay, on the hoist side. It was adopted shortly before the country's declarations of independence from Britain on 3 September. Qatar flag is the only national flag having a width more than twice its height. 1971, which it is formed. The flag is very simple to the flag of the neighboring country. Sorry, the flag is very similar to the flag of the neighboring country, Bahrain, which was fewer points, a 3.5 proportion, and a red color instead of maroon. Qatar flag is the only national flag having a width more than twice its height, as I told you earlier. Next slide, please. Qatar history. The history of Qatar from its first duration of human occupation to its formation is a modern state. Human occupation of Qatar dates back to 50,000 years ago. Qatar's modern history begins with conventionally in 1766 with the migration of the peninsula of families from Kuwait, notably the Al Khalifa. During the 1950s and 1960s, increasing oil revenues brought prosperity, rapid immigration, substantial social progress, and the beginning of the country's modern history. Qatar declared its independence on September 3, 1971. Next. Here we will learn about the area. It is 11,571 kilometers square. The currency of Qatar is Qatari Riyal. We will see in the next slide how Qatari currency looks. Okay. Population is 28.3 lakhs according to 2019. And capital, you all know, Doha. It is the richest country in the world. And Qatar is a very safe country to travel to. Saturday, 18 December is the Qatar National Day. In the ports, one of the most important ports is Hamad Port. And you also learned in the later slides, Hamad Airport also. Hamad Port is Qatar's main seaport located south of Doha in the Al Ol area. Construction of the port began in 2010. It became operational in December 2016. Next. In this slide, you can see the currency of Qatar and the Hamad Port of Qatar. Okay, construction of the port began in June 2010 and covering the area of 26 kilometers. The port is planned to have livestock, vehicle, and general terminals. An offshore supply depot. Hamad International Airport, I'll tell you about that. We will in later slide. We also learned about the Hamad International Airport. And it is the third best airport in the world. Here in Qatar, we are very competitive ones and we love being a winner. This is the main logo or main motto of the Qatar country. Next. Now we will learn about the Doha, the capital of Qatar. Doha is the capital and most populous city of Qatar. It has a population of 956,460 according to 2015. The city is located in the coast of Persian Gulf in the east of the country, north of Al Wakrah and south of Al Khor. It is Qatar's fastest growing city with over 80% of the nation's population living in Doha or its surrounding suburbs. The Doha Metro is a Guinness World Record breaking hopping on board the Doha Metro is a great way to get around the city for less. But did you know the project is actually world record breaking? During construction, it was awarded a world record for the largest number of tunnel boring machines operating simultaneously in a single project. Next slide, please. Now, let's have a look at amazing Doha. Qatar, official language. Arabic is the official language of Qatar. And you know, Qatari sign language is the language of deaf community. English is commonly used as a second language and a rising lingua franca. You must now confuse what is lingua franca. It is also known as bridge language, common language, or the trade language, which we use at the time of trading. Okay. English is particularly useful for communications with Qatar's large expatriate community. Next. Government of Qatar. It is the unitary semi-constitutional monarchy. Amir, the Amir of the state Qatar, is the monarch and the head of the state of Qatar, as well as the commander-in-chief of the armed forces and guaranteed of the constitution. It is the most powerful position in the country and has a prominent role in foreign relations. Tamim bin Ahmad, which you can see on the left-hand side of your screen, the person is Tamim bin Ahmad. We can call him His Highness Sheikh Tamim bin Ahmad Al Thani. This is the real name, which is very big. That's why we only say Tamim bin Ahmad. Now the Prime Minister Khalid bin Khalifa, which is on the right hand side, served as a Prime Minister of Qatar and Minister of Interior since 28 January 2020. The political system of Qatar is de facto absolute monarchy, with the Emir of Qatar as head of state and head of government. Qatar is not a democratic country. Next slide, please. Qatar sports cultures combines the traditional sports of Arab desert society and modern Western sports. Football is the most popular and most played sport in Qatar, and the cricket, golf, tennis, horse racing, basketball, swimming, table tennis, volleyball. All these sports are also played in the Qatar, but football is the most popular and played sport in Qatar. Traditional sport is Arabian horse racing, camel racing, and falconry. I will tell you in the later slide about the falconry. Sport in Qatar is primarily centered on football in terms of participation and spectators. Next slide, please. Okay, here are some pictures related to places and various sports team of Qatar. You can also see the logo of their sports team. First picture of Qatar is of Qatar International Golf Club. The golfing revolution is underway in the Middle East, and believe it or not, this golf revolution is in Qatar. This is the story behind the all new Qatar International Golf Club, a place that believes everyone can be a golfer. Second picture is of Qatar football team. Third picture is of tennis players. Fourth picture is of cricket team logo. Next slide, please. Okay, here the first picture is of falconry. It is the hunting of wild animals in their natural state and habitat by means of trained bird of prey. Small animals are hunted, like squirrels and rabbit, often fall prey to these birds. The practice of hunting with a conditional falconry bird is also called hawking or game hawking. The next is the camel racing, and you can see the picture of horse racing. Okay. And this is the same picture, the team of the football team of the Qatar country. Next slide, please. Now we will know about the Qatar national animal is urban ox. The urban ox is the national animal of Jordan, Oman, the United Arab Emirates, Bahrain, and Qatar. The Arabian ox or white ox is a medium-sized antelope with a distinct shoulder bump, long straight horns, and a tufted tail. Since the Arabian ox is so important in Qatar and is its proud national animal, it made perfect sense to have an icon that stood out because of its significance to the country. It played a major role in Qatar and Qatar Airways. Also, in Qatar Airways, it has the logo of this animal. We will see in later slides. The Arabian ox was extinct in the wild by early 1970s, but was saved in zoos and private purses. Next slide, please. This is the national flower of Qatar, the Qataf. The Qataf is the Qatar's national flower and grows along the country's coastline. Qataf is also known as Limonium or sea lavender. Has pink or lilac flowers that grow in cluster from a bright red bud. Please mute. From a bright red bud and can be seen in Qatar from the months of March to May. Next slide, please. This is the national attire of Qatar. The man which is wearing it is called thob. The thob is the national attire for men in Qatar. It's a pristine white long robe like clothing or tunic that covers the whole body from the wrist right down to the ankles. The top half of the thob is tailored like a shirt but reaches down to the ankle and is loose fitting. A pair of loose white trousers called the sirwal is always worn under the thob. The thob has long been part of the culture of Qatar, which has been preserved even today by the young and the old alike. Next slide.
Ma'am, yes. The national dress for Qatar is the woman's is the burqa, right?
Yes. Okay, now we will learn about the Qatar national tree. It is called the Sidra tree. In the Qatari culture, the Sidra tree is the iconic symbol of the country's heritage. The Sidra has grown in the desert of Qatar for generations. With roots that reach deep into the earth, fruit and flowers that nourish and leaves that heal. The Sidra become a beacon of comfort in the harsh desert environment, allowing leaf to flourish. Next slide, please. Previous one, okay. Now let's see the Qatar top 5 tourist places.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now we will see the Qatar Airlines. Next slide, please. This is the scheduled airlines, Qatar Airlines Airways Company. QCS cooperating as Qatar Airways is the state-owned flag carrier of Qatar. The headquarter is the Qatar Airways Tower in Doha. The airline operates a hub and spoke network linking over 150 international destinations across Africa, Asia, Europe, the Americas, and Oceania from the base of Hamad International Airport using a fleet of more than 200 aircraft. Qatar Airways Group employs more than 43,000 people. Next slide. This is the Gulf Helicopters. Gulf Helicopters is a helicopter services provider mainly servicing the oil and gas industry in Middle East, Yemen, North Africa, and India. It is a 100% subsidiary of Gulf International Service under the Qatar Petroleum umbrella and has its headquarters in Doha, Qatar. Next slide, please. Qatar Executive is a business jet subsidiary of Qatar Airways based in Doha. It was launched on June 16, 2009 at the Paris Air Show. Apart from its core business of aircraft charters, Qatar Executive Service portfolio also includes aircraft management, maintenance, and full range of fixed-based operation. Next slide, please. This is the government airlines. Qatari Amiri Flight is a VIP airline owned and operated by the government of Qatar. It operates worldwide, chartered on demand, and caters exclusively to the royal family of Qatar and other VIP government staff. The vast majority of its fleet is painted in the standard livery of the commercial flag carrier of Qatar, Qatar Airways. Next slide, please. El Khor Airport is located in the south of El Khor in Qatar. The airport is mostly used by general aviation aircraft. And also, mute everyone. The fly-in lasts for 2 days and allows visitors to travel in and view aircraft. Next slide, please. This is the Hamad International Airport. It is the sole international airport in the state of Qatar, located south of its capital, Doha. It placed the former Doha International Airport as Qatar's principal airport. Next slide. Now, quickly see this videos about the Qatar Airways. Qatar.
Yeah, it was nice.
So anyone remember the national animal of Qatar?
Ma'am, it's falcon.
No, it's not falcon. No one knows the national animal.
This national animal is oryx.
Yes, correct.
Miss, every time I write it down.
Yes, that's why you remember.
Okay, have you done your task? I have asked you to draw a map of Qatar. Have you done that? Nobody did.
Shubhanita is showing something, but we can't see because of his background.
Oh, Oh, ma'am, I didn't do the task because I was not there in the last previous class because I needed to go to a family function. I went to a family function. Is it okay, ma'am?
Okay. Okay, those who have attended, they didn't do. Okay, Maitra.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you ready with
ma'am,
the presentation?
Ma'am, I did it. Ma'am, I don't have the option to present, ma'am.
Okay, wait, Maitra. We are making you co-host.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, Maitra, you can present now.
How the daily present panitra? Ma'am, can you see it?
Yes.
Take one and I'll present here. Today, I would like to talk about the country, Qatar. This is the flag of Qatar, and this is the coat of arms. This is the traditional dress of the Qatar. This is the currency. Its name is Qatari Riyal, and one Qatari Riyal equals to 20.36 Indian rupees. And here is Qatar in the world map. It is located in the Asian continent. And this is the Emir of Qatar. His name is Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani. And house or the family of Thani has ruled Qatar since 1868. And the population is 2.83 million by nationality. And Indians are 21.8%, Bangladeshis are 12.5%, Nepalis is 12.5%, same. Please don't annotate on the screen. Qataris is 10.5%, Egyptians is 9.35%, Filipinos is 7.35%, Pakistanis is...
Maitra, you can close the annotate.
Yes. Maitra, you stop share and then share it again.
Okay. Now can you see it clearly?
You share the screen.
Ma'am, can you see it now?
No, Maitra, it is not visible.
Okay, just a minute.
Yeah, you can.
Yes, we can see now.
And Sri Lankans is 4.35%, others are 16.95%, and only 10.5% of population are local Qataris. Rest are in work for Qatar. And next is Qatar Airways, the national carrier. It has 227 aircrafts and it flies to 173 locations. And this is the National Museum of Qatar.
This museum looks like a flower, right?
Yes, ma'am. And the next one is Lusani Football Stadium. Qatar is conducting 2022 Football World Cup. And this is the Al Jansab Football Stadium. This is also a football stadium. And the next one is Torch Doha. It's the tallest building. And this is the Toronto Tower. And then the Pearl of Qatar. It's the artificial island. And the next one is Qatar Islamic Culture Center. And the next one is Qatar National Library. And Shukran. Shukran means thanks in Arabic language. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Maitra. That was a very good presentation.
Thank you, ma'am.
So anybody want to share anything? So that's all about our today's session. Hope you enjoyed our tour. See you in the next class.
Bye, ma'am. Have a nice day.
Bye, ma'am. Have a nice day. Bye, everyone.
Bye, everyone.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a nice day.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am. Bye, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, are you there?